Hello, my name is Dr. Linda Evans, and I'm a faculty member in the TESOL program at Kennesaw State University. TESOL stands for Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages. I want to take a few minutes to share with you a process for enhanced collaboration that we're using in a current school-university partnership and plan to expand to other partnerships both locally and globally. Our current partnership is with an elementary school in a neighboring county. The project is a writing project first piloted as Cuentos de mi Familia, or Stories of My Family, and it was an oral history project where students interviewed a family member and wrote their stories. The students in the program are 5th and 6th grade students from Guatemala or Mexico, and their home languages are either Spanish or an indigenous language called Mam. They have a wide range of proficiency levels in English, from verbally fluent to newly arrived and monolingual in Spanish or Mam. Other project participants include university pre-service education volunteers. Through the Cuentos project, these future educators gain perspectives about culturally and linguistically responsive teaching that is critical for teachers with English learners in their classes. The Education Alliance at Brown University identifies characteristics of culturally responsive teaching, including maintaining positive perspectives on parents and families, communicating high expectations, and designing instruction that is culturally mediated and student-centered, with the teacher as a facilitator of learning. Recognizing the strengths that English learners and students with disabilities possess, and understanding that these students are able to meet high expectations with appropriate scaffolding and support, are essential concepts for all teachers. In addition to the cultural aspects of the Cuentos project, the development of literacy skills was facilitated by the close collaboration between the students and pre-service volunteers. In writing their family members' stories, students were able to make a connection between school and home language, and the volunteers were able to see the benefits firsthand. Further, providing learners with the perspective that their stories, families, and experiences are valued changes the dynamic of deficiency too prevalent in the schools. After the pilot, we expanded the project to Cuentos de mi Vida, or Stories of My Life, where the students write about experiences, memories, or people who are important to them. Because we only met every other week, I wondered how best to deepen the connection between me, the ESOL teacher, the students, and the university volunteers. Building on the potential of an online environment, we decided to experiment with Voice over Internet Protocol, or VoIP, technologies. We selected Skype because it's free, reliable, and accessible by the school. School systems will often restrict websites that may be accessed in order to provide for greater security for their students. After working out the logistics, we were able to launch the virtual collaboration on the students' writing. This happened in two different ways. The first approach to this expanded collaboration was the students going to the media center, individual students reading their story drafts on camera, and the volunteers and I making comments and asking questions when the student had completed the reading. This gave the students experience with communicating via Skype, which many of them have never used, and with the notion of blended and online classrooms, another new concept for them. It provided them with additional input on their stories and an authentic audience for their writing, both the other students and me and the volunteers, which helps students to connect the speaking, reading, and writing domains of academic English. Students who rarely spoke up in class voluntarily read their stories, their confidence in speaking and reading aloud in English bolstered by the nature of the blended environment. A second approach to using Skype was for individual conferencing via an iPad. The ESOL teacher set up an iPad with Skype on a table in the classroom, and individual students brought their stories to read to me as I sat at my desk at the university. I had copies of their stories that the teacher had scanned and sent to me, which enabled me to provide feedback and ask questions for both revision and editing purposes. When working on writing projects with English learners, it's important to focus on the expression of ideas first and foremost. Then, once the ideas are expressed coherently and cohesively, sentence and word-level editing can take place. The editing phase provides the opportunity for mini lessons on grammar or spelling that are contextualized in the student's own work. By using the iPad Skype conferencing technique, I was able to provide individualized, authentic collaboration in real time. It also further enhanced the bonds between the students and me, providing them with another form of engagement with a caring educator. Finally, it was just really fun for both of us to be able to connect in such a cool way. In the future, we plan to use Skype and other VoIP technologies to connect this classroom with students in other classrooms both locally and globally. Connecting English learners in the U.S. with our partner school in Spain, for example, would allow both validation of students' native language and culture and authentic reasons for students in Spain to practice their English skills. We have only scratched the surface in terms of the capabilities of virtual conferencing, and we look forward to seeing what the future holds for our English learners and for us.